Hey everybody, how's it been? It's Monday, it's time to get back to our catch-up play for roots. Like the normal stream schedule, and I back in full swing, so back to Ace Attorney. When we last left off, on the Wednesday, we are on the second part of the trial on the fifth episode, The Adventures of the Blooded... I'm forgetting this one. Unspeakable Story, okay, The Adventures of the Unspeakable Story. We just got to the second part of the trial. Here's what it's gonna be like, so let's just get into this. Our defendant is Gino Lestrade, by the way. Hold up, please. Let us resume proceedings. Witness, you and I, Rick, take the stand. I presume you've heard the defense counsel summary examination? Oh, yeah, governor. Hey, gov, I did. Mr. and Mr. Skulkin. Poor blimey! This is going to be hard work. Earlier in the trial, you get the following testimony in regard about your actions after you had the windy bang. Well, it was Bedlam soon as, weren't it? It was not. It was. Didn't have time to pull my dukes out of my sea lockets. Error. That was a lie. Your brothers. Oh, blimey! On that question, you grab for the items on the victim's counter. We never done nothing of the sort. Oh, did you figure that out? Oh, did you figure that out? You will not get a formal testimony once again. You will tell the court precisely what happened on the night in question, and this time, you will tell the truth. Each lie that passes your lips serves to increase the severity of your punishment. And that, gentlemen, may deal a crushing blow to your chances of ever seeing the light of day again. A thought worth pondering, perhaps. Say no more, Gov. We hear ya. We blab, we squeak, we preach! Round two! Legal entry, the hotel. Alright, we did knock a few things over. Premier and Rafflin for nothing. It was when we had the gun, see, made us both jump, all the stuff went flying. Blimey, didn't get me the fright. We was thinking the shooter come out the door to get us next. We suck everything back we found and scabbard, stripped back into the black. I'm in the black. We couldn't have shot the pawnbroker, see? We never had the chance, did we? You met the defense's accusation. You did indeed ramsack Mr. Windybank's countertop on the night in question. Not ramsack, governor. No. That's right, Nash. That's right. It's more like we tied up. Yeah. Sorry. By their own admission, these brothers entered the pawnbrokery under dubious circumstances. However, they panicked and fled, hearing a gunshot having first made good their mess. So is it? Yeah, it sounds like rough at all. What's it all? We don't, Nash. We don't. Can't make him sound a bit more cutthroat. I think when these two men shoot up at Windy Bank Saturday night, there's more to their testimony than meets the eye. Sure of it. Oops. What did I say? Oh, there we go. Oh, look at that.
Hold it!
And that's the case. Now, why didn't you testify to that fact in the first place? Well, you know, we ain't exactly squeak clean, are we? Big Notch, we ain't. We admit it to something like that. People would think we was up to no good. Well said, Ringo, my old China. You China. We only land ourselves in even more trouble. And in fact, now, as a result of your lying in your previous testimony, that's exactly what you've done. Land yourself in even more trouble. That's rotten luck. Says the rotten apple eater. Witness, explain your actions to the court. Why did you ransack the victim's counter? We never ransacked nothing. Right, nice, right. More like we tidied the place up. Sorry.
Hold it!
So what you're saying is, the sound of the gunshots shook you so much you knocked all of those things off the counter? Well, it shocked one of us that much, yeah. Yeah, the bag owner. Nurse needs to keep its shit on. Look, it was loaded, right? Blimey, my decorator. He would have woken up to that bang. Big brother. Better screamed like a blooming baby and fell over the counter. He knocked over her little books, a kind of stick, and some skull was on. I got tangled up in some map, and it was knocked over a pitcher flame. And what knocked over? With them scales on the floor. Really massive the working quietly then. What a racket. Mikara, you would have been scared back into their grave a clatter like that. So in short, the gunshot took you by surprise.
Is that right?
And then some. I mean, it was quite the mess, and then all of a sudden, BAM! Inspector Grayson, do you have something odd? Like I was saying, I don't appreciate being lumped in with these scoundrels. No, something odd about their testimony? You seem to react just now to what Mr. Skulkin said. Then we can think of something. It's probably nothing, of course. I wouldn't even bother mentioning. Yes, probably nothing, of course. I wouldn't even bother to mention it only. Well, the fact is, cases don't get solved if you ignore the little details. Could you just tell us what's on your mind? As you know, we brought these fellas into the yard for questioning last night. And seem to give us told a slightly different story to what they're saying now. Did it? You claimed you heard the victim shout something out before the gunshot. Might have. Doesn't ring a bell. Well, you mentioned it. Granted, it's only a minor detail, but still. I can't help feeling like perhaps you've been a bit sloppy with your testimony here, fellas. I discovered a witness testimony to have been any more sloppy than his hypero. Proven to be. I shall be forced to bring in the very harsh punishment to bear against them. Easy, easy! We'll get it right this time! That's it, yeah! Don't come back to me now! Then speak! Supplement your testimony with whatever details have miraculously returned to your questionable minds. Sir. Right, you are. Gov. Just before the gunshot, we had a fight. See how nice. Give me the gun.
Hold it.
So in fact, you heard the voice of the gunshot almost simultaneously. Like, we're the Gov. We're in. Although, I suppose if I'm being honest, we are kind of wearing voice before the Yano. If you don't like a shot, give it a gun! Bam! Kind of thing. Career in acting tragically missed. Brr, guys. I'm worried where the voice is coming from, can you tell? Of course you could! From the other side of the door behind the counter, it was... Storming? Where the victim was found there. The voice you heard, it was that of the victim, Mr. Windy Bank. Oh, my granny's life! Of course it was! Oh, and his granny's life! Of course it was! So that would mean that you both knew Mr. Wimack and the sound of his voice. Yeah, so that would mean what? But not or any ideas? Yes, Council, indeed it would. No, we didn't know the geezer. Or am I supposed to deny it when the bloke all the fancy clobber and get us an evil, the evil eye. If you value your lives, you will ensure the testimony is accurate and true. Oh, my granny's life, it is. On his granny's life, it must be. A good job, his granny's dead. Ouch. Summarized then, immediately after hearing the voice of the victim, you heard the gunshot. Causing you to stumble and upset the items on the counter, scattering them on the shop floor. You make it sound like we're clumsy. Don't forget we tied you up like good little boys. Anyway, the way I see it... The bloke one who owned this place was holding a gun, so he... in the fire instead of yelling at the girl.
Hold it!
You're saying the Mr. Wimack had the gun in his hand? Oh yeah! But that was a sight, eh? Them two waving them guns at her must have gotten pretty heated. I mean, just before sure, no. We are the to say if you don't want to get shot. Doesn't really sound like a man with mind. More than the threat, you could say. But the Rebbe was known to keep a revolver on a shop counter at all times. People say that to protect the articles in his keeping, he rarely pulled a bullet in someone's head if required. That's someone being himself, of course. Good grief! Extraordinary devotions indeed, if alarmingly misguided. Well, it's certain. It sounded like it was ready to pull the trigger the other night. Only the person he's gonna shoot beat him to it. Cooked his goose proper. But I wish he squeezed the trigger here instead of wasting time shooting. Give me the gun! And it was directly after those words that you heard the gunshot. It was more or less the same time, Gov. Give me the gun! Bam! Kind of thing. Yes, a career in acting very tragically missed. Damn, we had a designer summoned in the deck before everything went dead quiet. After that, we done a slapdash job tidying the place up. Mommy, eh? Oh yeah, we've heard this one more. So, you didn't try to open the storeroom door then? Not in your life! It went deadly quiet after that, it did. But the wind right at me. Anyway, the door was locked, wasn't it? There's no way it was open. Yes, of course. It was locked from the inside, so we were being led to believe.
It was, Gov! It was, from the inside! Right. We had no way to know what was going on in there, did we?
Unless there was some other way to get the fury from inside the storeroom. Like for a keyhole or a spy hole, perhaps?
Don't ring no bells, don't light no lights. We all got in the run before we noticed anything like that. We stuck on our teeth in the skin, see? But one day... We really cut the mustard! Well, really cut the mustard!
He's... How did I... As we know, behind the door was the victim's lifeless body, and the accused not 2 feet away. Yes, unfortunately. Gina was in there, unconscious, forgot with the gun in her hand. Confirm, would it be correct to say that neither of you set foot inside the storeroom?
That's right, Gov, that's right. Good enough, he never wanted to.
We stuck everything back where we found. Oh, yeah. Yes, whereupon you fired a shot from your own gun to Mr. Herlock Jones.
Yeah. He was a bit nasty there. Was nasty, was. Truth be told, I was already shaking like a leaf when your lot turned up.
You were shaking like a leaf? Don't put a little gun in your hand!
Good advice, miss. Good advice. If you don't, my mind went totally blank.
Where your man goes, Holy Pike, make sure you don't put a little gun in your hand! You don't have a little gun in your hand.
Better know me, miss. After that, we legged it down the street, but... Apparently, we looked dodgy to the coppers or somewhat, so to clap the door, being us like wanking.
Wilkin. And after your handcuffs, the police found this revolver in your possession, correct?
Well, yeah. Listen, that proves it, don't it, eh?
Hold it!
And why should we believe that?
Yeah, what? Cause it's true, isn't it? The place was totally empty when we went in.
At that time, the victim was already in the storeroom. I've been forced to open the door by the accused who had a gun on his head. To his head's heart. In other words, on the night question, these two witnesses never even laid eyes on the perpetrator of the pump robbery, Mr. Windy Bang. Correct.
You got it, mister! Down to the T!
So, the Skullcrawlers never actually encountered Mr. Minivan. Is that really true, I wonder? That's it? That's the full extent of our testimony.
What's it, Runo?
Look, very fierce. I could pour you some herbal tea if you're tired.
Oh, thank you, but I'm fine.
Being such a logical thinker, you probably laugh. But it feels like those birds are still hiding something. Something important. It is nothing more than a feeling, though. I've got no proof to support it.
Well, feelings can be very logical at times.
Are
they? People's expressions, the movement in her eyes, the words they choose.
You can take it in and your brain will quietly analyze it to come up with a feeling that, like you described. You concluded that there's something suspicious about this testimony without knowing why, that's all.
I think it's just your instincts.
Iris, thank you. Sometimes I think if she's 10 years old, I must be 5.
Okay. Wait. I might want to present that, but at the same time, maybe not. Bullet entered from the body from the back on the gentleman. Let me press this again.
Hold it!
Some.
Hold it.
Let's push a bit more. It does feel like the statement could be a statement. Okay. Well, I pressed it and he was saying, "Hey agent, how you doing?" "I'm doing good." Oh, didn't. That accomplished nothing. That's good to hear. Yeah, that accomplished nothing. Okay. All right.
Objection.
No, that was not it. Yeah, that's the same we need to focus on. Ow. What about give me a gun? Right. No, it's not happening with the stereoscope.
Objection.
Okay, that was just Bobby Bunt. Tomorrow, we're gonna have normal streams for like 2 weeks. My ideas are backfired. Yeah, I picked the wrong one. Oh. I'm an idiot.
Objection.
I'm an idiot. Let me restart. I realized where I went wrong. I was on the wrong statement on this. It was the crime scene photo before! Oh, the photo before the crime.
for the expression. The victim to make was wielding a gun. He was not. Get the picture. It's not as it is, of course. And yet the photograph evidence from the scene shows Ceramic wasn't holding the gun.
Objection!
Does the defense really intend to hide it in the comp? Oh, right, that screws us up a bit, because we suggest only Gina had the gun. The defendant has failed to stop. That's signature of the team. Ouch. Huh. To the right, Nash. To the right, you geezer. Hard thing. Ah, damn it. Well, I was kind of right. Okay. But yeah, no, we should, like I said, streams tomorrow might have run the same time as this one. I don't know. So it was not. Okay, so the look went. Mommy didn't give her half right. He was thinking. I don't know, actually. I really don't know. I'll have to debate about that tomorrow. Might. I don't know. I'm trying to remember. Is there. I don't remember there's anything like Rise Stories 2 this week. Rise is probably most likely going to be a Saturday. GM debating about it and still thinking about it. Okay. Ooh, whoa. No. Yeah, she's fired and stuff. What are you thinking? Oh, nice. Nice one. First up air and then. Ooh. Ooh, nice. Maybe. Oh, that gives us not. Right, that's no new information. Yeah, nice one, agent. Oh. Oh, yeah, right. Ah. Nice to play it. Okay. Part of me was gonna say you got lucky, but you probably planned it well.
Gun.
Ah.
So yeah, you planned that out well.
Yeah.
Hold it!
Rob! Liberal Center, some story. Ah. Oh, yeah, cause that's Hell's Gate too. Be stupid here. Cover street.
Objection.
Nope. That's not it. I don't want to turn. Turns in neutral B, downs in smash comp. Puzzle. Ah. Oh, yeah, because that's Jalvar, but. Okay. Why did I add something? Oh, wow. That's the wrong direction. Yeah.
Hold it.
I hit L1 again. Oh, why do I keep doing that? Let's have to see this tragically missed moment. Okay.
Objection.
Okay, at least it's not the Allspy report, which was a also bad idea.
Objection.
I really, it's the crime scene for that one. Please don't tell me I just went back in circles again.
Objection.
Yeah, so I would no arguments with Zaprov the skill cap thing. Wait. Oh, this is the actual one. Actually, couldn't you just do half and half tomorrow? I don't know.
Objection.
Okay. Ultra. Yeah. I guess he did some online watches of animation today. Oh. Oh yeah, because the thing says the back. I love this friend.
Take that.
Okay, according to her testimony, seems to have her shot a gun. Oh, a gunshot. Ah, but the other guy for states knew such thing happens. Okay, however. Before. I think we may have found a break for it. Well, shot that night. Check quick, Alec Gunn hand that we saw with her own bleeding ass. Did you actually? Uh oh. Someone messed up. Uh oh. Yep. And that question that you saw that the remains affected me on the gun only mean that despite their testimony to the contrary, scumbers must have encountered the victim in person. We may get to see you the model then. Order! Yourself for once. Yes, I'm supposed to seeing that my previous warning found deaf ears. I made a quick clear that false witness would be the deaf ear. Oh, the Reaper might sick the scythe. You must see untrue viewers nice. Victorian London. It's pronounced differently. My order. I know what you mean, like order. But I think back then it was order. I'm actually going to double check this, actually. I was going to make sure I got the spelling right. Okay, yeah. It's old English. I think it's just the way it would say it back then. Or I think it's just a specific way that Victorians would have said that. I miss him there. I just we were correct now. Should be blab now. You knew what else to do. Somebody's doing something. We're sitting here perfectly clear. We will talk. There's no other option available for you. Oh. Keeps up. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I'm assuming it's just times as well. Victorians, English may have a distinctly different language than us. Yeah, is it? Like I said, I think it's just a specific way back then, so it doesn't really have an effect now. Question. Sean. Yeah, it's a Victorian slang. It's Victorian slang. That's what it is. It's Victorian slang. Well, we just got to actually see some Victorian. Glad to see some of the slangs also survived the test of time. Because, yeah, that's. You can definitely tell there's a good bit of slang. Lou McGillick used a lot of Irish slang. Okay. The testimony. Enter with the victim. Alright, so we just got inside and got in it. And have a sign of relief when the geezers show. So with a smug. Give me the gun, but no, and then they flew. Let us like it was possessed. I thought we had it. For no geezer, the bloke was strong as an ox. It chuckled me over the counter. I put me gone on them and then I legged it for the door in the back room. He never had nothing to do with the killing them. That's all what happened. Bob and this way. Oh, I think I'm messing up some of this language myself. They're telling us the moment before the victim was killed in the storm room. I can encourage him in the meal. Well, yeah. It's lottery. Well. Parents house an interesting juncture. This changes matters considerably. But honest governor this time. And that's just saying, we ain't got enough more yard. Okay, so the events proceed with the cross donation. This blood. That's it. F-24. You must press the information and then go from there.
Hold it!
Okay. We're in the banks. Who else? Sorry. Just keeping a close eye on the entrance to the gaff, obviously. But we never thought no one was gonna come in back room like that. Back room being the pun. Okay, stone room. Yeah, that must have been where he popped off from. Only place they could have been. So it seemed the victim was already in the storeroom when these brothers entered the premise. Which means Jeannie must have been in there at that point as well. That doesn't make sense, does it? Did Jeannie have friends with Meg in the storeroom with her gunpoint? Then why would he have emerged from the same room all alone when the brothers were at? What? No. Is she accused of the time? What? The motor troll? Didn't tell you. Wait, Clubba. We have bigger fists to find it. Me and Neil either just lost it. I feel like I'm getting some of the slang right and I'm getting some of it wrong. You must have been trying to shit at these words
Yeah. Terror. Although I also believe he's got... he metaphorically has a gun to his head now.
Are you claiming you heard him yelling at the other side of the storm door?
Did we? But in truth, he was shouting as much as you. Yeah!
The Muslim man gonna go on attack.
Is he ever blaming me? A great ugly battery that pointed straight at me for this piece.
Oh boy.
What you're saying is, he definitely saw money bank with a gun at the time, right? There's golf, it is spot on. All of a sudden, came to this, he did. It was Bedlam? I don't know who was going for her.
Very far in shutter.
Not shed, before we add it, I mean. We're no geezer, the bloke was strong as an ox. He took me over the counter.
Hold it!
Yes, I know you mentioned.
Enter. Please wait.
Okay. Got a little book, so kind of sick, and some skulls. Hold on. I'm gonna be warm when we get around to doing the second one. There might be more of this.
Hey, got tangles in the end. Was knocked over a picture frame.
Knocked them scales on the floor. And sent a gunshot that struck me. Big bruv, it went flying over a counter like a gunshot, I can tell you. Then the old geezer pin him. Nah, she did. If you hadn't been there, the look would have flattened me like a blooming pancake in seconds. At the time of question, the alarm rings at the local police station via the secret cable in the palm brokery. There is a button under the counter to use to activate it, which was presumably pressed by the victim. Right. The rush fled the scene. I'm back on the street. Rushed straight into the arriving police, didn't they? Because anyway, everything could protect this shop. I pulled me gun. Then he laid in that door in the back room.
Hold it!
And the shoot went through the bank. No. Never, I was just, you know. We're gonna firm her bra, won't I? It's been fun, don't forget. I know my man whose shop was being burgled, yes. Oh, you doing swords to Hyman cool off? I haven't hit 22 minutes. I was like 2 minutes off.
And then the man fled into the storeroom. We put the gun in him, was it?
That was it. Shoved me away, then ran off the. Not from that door. Oh, through the door. And shut himself in. That's first thing. 30 seconds off.
Ooh.
Definitely. Oh! How'd that go?
What am I missing in the bank?
Well, according to what everyone's saying, Ginny was there waiting for him with a gun. Ah, yes, that's right. Ginny allegedly used Mr. Winnie Mike's gun to threaten him. Yeah! Yes.
Okay.
That's our 22. Oh, okay.
You're rough.
Yeah, like I said, I think with the one time we downstream, I got 24 minutes.
Hold it.
Oh. Up and goes, nothing, you'll get your money. Okay. It's in the door now. Go to a straw, we can punch in the chair. And the stream reach.
Yeah, I might try. I haven't tried Hiram Cool Ups in Sand, so I might give it a shot at some point.
The person who had possibly shot the victim defused Mr. Genius Trade. Where's it? They did that console. I'm gonna save. I'm gonna say no one for now. Right, choose them. Oh.
Ouch. Oh. Yeah, it does, unfortunately. Feel sorry for not hurting.
White ice, waiting, smoking, hobby. That's pretty much the trial in a nutshell. His trial runs in a nutshell. Wait. I think I get it. Maybe. Well, let's not use that gun. Which one has that option? Is it, I think? Oh no, it's thin.
Hold it!
Okay. I think I could probably say either an unknown assailant. Oh no. This is a risk. What was I looking for? In the moment you minute you with things face to face at night. Of course, this child changed completely. So it did. Friend. Question one of Sandra is, who could have shot Mr. Nimeng? Is it a defense that the defendant was not... not only possible to answer up. Answer. Right, because they encountered him, they would have seen... Ah, that changes everything. Got my attention. In that case, let's return to this plan premise. The victim is killed in the storm ring, which was locked from the inside. Those are the facts, so pray. What other possible answer to the question that the man be? No answers. Two, my lord. Twice as many chances to be right, maybe? Indeed, namely. From where, what location did the company shoot the victim at? Furthermore, where was the victim at the time? I think I know. Yes, this might be the possible location. Okay. 9, 10% clear. Show the court the plans, the answer to the store ship. If you believe someone could have killed the victim, indicate where that person could have fired the gun.
Take that!
Vance believes the corporate would have been shot from this location here. And the answer to the second question. Assuming the corporate fired from the location indicated, where was the victim at the time? Hubbard shot the victim from outside the store. Continue. The turnip died instantly from a bullet wound in his back. Looking at the stained blood stain, it doesn't appear the body was moved after death. Which tells us he was almost certainly shot while he was in the storeroom. However, where was the shooter when the fatal bullet was fired? So you are adamant that the shot was fired from the outside of the room. Well, according to the Skull Brothers' earlier testimony, I pulled my gun at him and he legged it from the door into the back room. Minibanks ran away from the door. We would have assumed that the door was open at the time. Ah! It was at this precise moment when the victim was from his life that these brothers had a perfect opportunity to shoot the man in the back once he was inside the door. Yeah, girl! Come to think about it, do you remember what the prosecutor said at the start of this trial? Moving on to the findings of Scotland Yard's coroner. This received the bullet under the body on a rising diagonal trajectory. It means the victim was likely shot by someone significantly shorter in length than himself. Poor man, shot while he's running as fast as he could to safety. Ah, of course! He'd have been leaning forward if he was running away. If the bullet was fired horizontally, it was still under the body from up trajectory. The culprit isn't necessarily someone short of missing when they bang. I'm sure my learned friend can't have forgotten. The storm sword was found closed and locked from the inside. You claim the victim was shot when he was fleeing the room. You also claim that his corpse was also disturbed enough to turn the key in the lock. But what if someone else locked the door? Yes, there must be someone else who could lock the storm door. And so... Very well then, counsel. Present your hypothesis to the court. In the scenario just described, the defendant asserts that the victim was shot from outside the court. In which case, who shut the storm door from the inside? How did it take the long way? Obviously, the person who locked the door was the only other person inside the room at the time. The defendant, Gina Lestrian.
Objection.
So, sir, she has said the accused deliberately engineered the sealed room. For what possible reason? Such action was only served to tighten the noose over her neck. I'm inclined to agree, I must say. Well, counsel? Yes, that's a tricky one, isn't it? Oops. Happy Pigeon has no place in my record. Remember that, please. First, Ginny, we have locked the door. Zelma goes to a saying, doesn't it? Does? Well, if I was Ginny in that situation, anyway, I would have locked the door as quickly as I could. I mean, those two burglars had just fired a gun in her direction, haven't they? Yes, obviously. Before the two brothers arrived, Miss Lestrade and Mr. Windbank were in the storeroom together. Now, I don't know what went on between them at the time, but at some point, Mr. Winnie Mac must have heard the breaking into the shop and left the storeroom.
Sure, Snake. That's us, bruv.
If your theory was correct, that would leave the accused alone in the storeroom.
Yes, I would.
Then, probably only moments later, the victim fled back to the storeroom, hoping to escape danger. Hit in the back by the bullet, Mr. Bingley fell to the floor where he was, inside the storeroom. And we have to ask ourselves now, what would the defendant have done in that moment?
Ah! I see where you're going with this!
Outside the storeroom was a terrifying killer who had just murdered Mr. Winnie Mac. As soon as the fall struck Miss Astrid, she slammed the door shut and locked it. In order to save her own life!
Hold it!
But I mean, we ain't the ones who done it! We ain't! You gotta believe us! I mean, come on, we never shoot no one!
Objection. That's plain untrue. I know a fact you would. Because before my eyes, you shot Mr. Herlock Jones! Only one logical conclusion here. So, Mr. Skulkin, you brought us an added opportunity to have been the true perpetrators of Mr. Winnie Bank's murder. Where does this leave us? You mean to say it wasn't the pickpocket who shot the pumper after all? You know, we're so free. Brother, she is
a dense forest.
Please, Bruno, I'm sure the jury seems to be firmly on your side now. I know, first time ever, I'm probably the last.
Well, I think you've done it. Sure, they have to give us a verdict of not.
An admirable effort, my learned friend.
Let's die.
Laughing. Find the situation amusing, law of seek. I find myself I defense the arguments most persuasive. I'd better say. Such chivalry is the bread and butter of the straight performance of your profession's Eastern nation. But such blatant malice constructor tricks amounts to nothing more than an inexcusable the fog over here. What? The hypothesis you put forward so obtusely credit this cannot and will not stand.
Because you see, it contains a fatal flaw.
A fatal flaw? Do you mean to tell me that you're out of world of your logic's falling? I say, Lord Fancyk. Might be an idea to explain this Bali conjure tricks or what that is to the troops on the ground, hmm?
Bit of flaw in my learned friend's argument is really very simple to understand.
No! Not the glass!
Assuming you're not tuned in with it to count bullets.
My George, count bullets!
Oh dear. He noticed then. Huh? Talking about.
Mental?
Yes, sir. Hello, court. How many bullets were found in the scene of the crime?
Two bullets.
Correct. The first, that was struck the victim in the back and his life. And the second, that was struck the detective, Mr. Herlock Sholmes, on his arrival at the scene.
Indeed.
The defense presented the picture showing the damage caused by the second bullet earlier in the proceedings. The bullet which entered Mr. Sholmes appears to have passed through his body to strike the calendar.
Your lordship understanding is correct.
Furthermore, we know there are two firearms involved in the incident. The revolver belonged to the victim, Mr. Windy Bank, and the Skulkin Brothers revolver.
The evidence shows that a single bullet was fired from each gun.
Yes, indeed it does. A single bullet from each. Now then, my learned friend. You yourself told the court only moments ago that these two brothers shot Mr. Product Showman's right before your eyes. Yes, I did. Goodness! I think you'll find that if a single bullet was fired from the brothers' gun and hit Mr. Showman's, it means Winnipeg was not shot by the same gun. Stop. Only one bullet. Stop. Exactly. Yes, this Nipponese street performer presents an intensely credible argument. However, it was never anything more than a virtual trick with no hope of standing up to scrutiny.
Order!
Yes, the bottle! Pray forget this courtesy of flinging the dregs of this hollow nectar into the public gallery. That would you describe eating a bottle of wine? No offensique. I'll be getting the boot! This court needs to open its eyes. Miss Jean Astray is no ordinary girl, despite her young age. Years, she can regrettably no longer be described as a juvenile. No. Person in the docks is far from a law-abiding citizen. She has a past written with criminal conduct. The truth is, the accused broke into the Paul Burger on the night of question with lonesome intent. You see, beyond this print, which depicts her threatening the victim with a murder weapon. I have here in my possession one more piece of evidence that the prosecution wishes to present. I'll be taking what is to be extended to the yard, thank you very much. Don't give it them. It's mine, that is. Mine. Sorry, miss. But anything belonging to Bigger Lakes has to be taken in as evidence now. Yes, that means about this. It's Felix's music box disc. Fair day before the hateful murder of Mr. Moneybank, the accused attempted to make off this article, which clearly doesn't belong to her. With none of this up to of a pickpocket, I might add, but by brute force and brazen impudence. Oh, gracious!
Okay.
Nick, no mistake, any sympathy for the accused on account. And the cage of her years of misguided and dangerous. There are no deaths, Mrs. Girl, which it pushed no crime she would not commit. Court forgets the fact that's Pearl. Let's see. I figure you're prone to take this music box disc in the evidence console. As a grim testament. To the defense. Then it's Kydra. Hold it. Oh, Fancy. I. Inspector Grayson? What? Yes, Inspector. We had a missing meeting yesterday at the yard by the prosecution service, and, I think it was agreed that that does should not be. Wouldn't be used as evidence. What's this all about? I see Inspector acting strangely. This is the first time he said anything to Lord Fancy. And seek at all. I am unaware of such meeting. Any such meeting? But those were the instructions, right? From the top of the government bigwigs? Inspector, I am the prosecution. And I alone determine how to present my case. Your warning is noted. Thank you. prosecution wishes to proceed with submitting this discus evidence, my lord. Deep out of. We now have the missing disc. Again. Prosecution has established the accused's motives, opportunity, and baseless of character. Oh, we're in Louis. This is blood. Yes, you're right. It's just a small smear, but definitely blood. Actually, I feel. And so I might have noticed that before. Then it's my first. My time to shine. I've been waiting forever. Alright, hold that this. Oh, so that this, Bruno. Let me get this in quickly, Iris. The flash. God. Rain? Oh, lovely white shit again. Wait, that color. What is it? It's just that green. It's. Isn't the first time we've seen the color, is it? We're going. The man you defended a couple of them, so is in the room. Yes! Or rather, mistakenly defended. What was his name doing in the back of this disc? I wish I'd looked the answer to him myself. We had like green. Oh! Hello! Shomes! There's nothing more to add. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I await your informed decision and the rest of my case. Leaving! I had the jury in my sight for once! For all. Well, 5 minutes! Or for us, too. In the air. It wasn't even for 5 minutes, Bruno. Hold on! I wonder if I might say something at this point. See, Mr. Foreman? Been stumbling about in a bit of a fog up until now, if truth be told, but all of a sudden. The answer is plainly obvious to me and my man. There's only one thing for it. Oh no. It's guilties. We're in again. And jury, ladies and gentlemen, will your procedure lean to defend this culpability?
Guilty.
Oh, we have to do it again. Crap. Now, consent is among the jury, it seems. When you've eliminated the impossible, whatever remains must be the truth. It's my line! I wrote that! For Hurley! I dare you sit against us! Don't worry, Iris. I don't think we're finished yet. Still more of those cases than we realized. It must be. Because there's one thing I'm absolutely certain of. Gina didn't shoot Winston Wright. That's beyond any doubt. Very well. You may proceed with the second summary examination of the day. Yes, quick on that. Thurman, are you and your juror ready? Cab squadron is primed and ready for action, sir. Very good. The gentleman the jury. You want to explain on what grounds you have determined the defendant to be guilty? Judicial findings. The juror's contentment. Once a rogue, always a rogue, I say. Different breed to us law-abiding citizens. As only two bullets were found in the scene, I would say the whole case is done and dusted. You don't need a stereoscope to see the truth here. Each which way you look at it, it was that pickpocket. I never imagined that a simple operation would cause me such grief. The accused attempted a theft on the previous day. I can see See, I'm in for a busy day indeed. I am a ballistic expert. I have seen many shootings. There is nothing I don't know about guns. It was seen there is little remaining room for doubt. Have you been? I was rather bowled over by the arguments put forward by the chap in black. But when that falls apart like a house of cards, I saw that I jolly didn't get. That's the first time I've ever heard that. Well, no more! The whole courtroom is turning against me. It's not fair, Iris. The prosecutor's being mean. Just because Ginny's done something means she shouldn't have done the past. That doesn't make her a murderer. Allow me to savor this fruity vintage. And while I savor the spectacle of your fruitless debate on the matter. Here's to the truth coming out. Eventually. That's enough from Ramble. Kenzel, proceed with your summary examination. Yes, Malone. Jury examination. The defendant's rebuttal. Well then. Just because Miss Lestrade has a history of pickpocketing, she must be guilty of murder. Is that what you're saying? Well. Are all members of the British Army so quick to judge? I beg your pardon? Are you mocking Her Majesty's Armed Forces, the greatest military organization in the world? I picked George on this one at this current day and time. No, I'm simply illustrating my point. Making assumptions about people because they're so. Your or pickpocket is wrong and dangerous. Well, yes, might have a point there, I suppose. But let's not forget the girl had already shown she had it in her from before. She's clearly a criminal sort through and through, can't deny it. When you said that she showed she had it in her, are you referring to this? Exactly. Tried to swipe down on you there, or am I mistaken? Not exactly. Even then, I was actually there at the time. It's hard to refute that. I've never actually seen the real thing. I might have to have a close look at it. Oh yes, of course. Mr. Shrooms did use his camera bar. Meant to make a copy of this, didn't he? And then ordered every type of music box he could find from across Europe. We still don't know what tune it plays, though. Could be. I'd love to see hi in the original compared to Huey's copy. It looks disc. Could be a clue some high. Perhaps we should send them in more detail. Didn't we? Blood. That's some fingertips. Well deducted. Not just someone's fingertips. Those are Benedict's fingertips. A man dressed in white? Yes, it happened that afternoon in Windy Banks. Gina tried to snatch this from the man's hands. The sharp little bumps cut his phone. Legend is, someone tries to grab a music box disc? Let it go quickly. The lessons don't snatch things, surely.
Hold it!
It's the number of bullets that has you convinced. Only two bullets were fired, and of the two guns that fired, they have been examined by the police. When the power man asked me how many the arthritis for thinner, I always tell her to count the table settings. Well, that's logical, I suppose. Although, yes. Sometimes after dining, Crockery does come missing. What if you guess rather like a fine china, the fine china? Was your employer dime of thieves? So I suppose if there's another bullet somewhere of which we were unaware, I have to reconsider my position. Another bullet somewhere in the scene. That'd be possible. At this point, I can't. Fortunately, when two bullets were discovered by the police during her investigation. Yes and no. Right. And I don't imagine the good man at Scotland Yard would have overlooked things. If I miss a bullet while I was cleaning his lordship's office, well, I should receive a sound scolding, I don't doubt. And he received a visit from the police. Perhaps it sounds like a crime scene to me. A fur bullet. It would completely turn things around if there was one, wouldn't it? I think we might find one lying around somehow. Oh, this is okay. I don't know why I'm summoned. This might not have much point.
Hold it!
So if I've understood correctly, you need two pitchers, a left eye one and a slightly different right eye one. Exactly. Thing is, he's seen in three dimensions, like this. So if you had two bullets, I don't suppose you could see anything useful with them. I think you'll find that no matter how different you squint, the trip of the situation is almost the same here. It's the same here. The person could have been shot. Could have shot the victim in that girl in the dark. I can be sure of that. Think about it. The skull converter shot the great detective, didn't he? Yes, that's been mentioned once or twice. Or thrice. Well then. Surely it's coming to focus now, isn't it? That was a waste of time. Not going to change my mind anytime soon. I never imagined that a simple operation was...
Hold it!
Would you please stop muttering about things that have nothing to do with this trial, sir? The defendant's life's on the line here! Well, the thing is... I couldn't... Really say that has nothing to do with this child, to be honest. Huh? I mean, there's no question that the mom was shot, but the bullet has simply vanished from his stomach. It's quite inexplicable, don't you think? I almost want to ask, but the surgery you've been muttering about all the time, you were operating on... What was the fellow's name now? Herlock Jones by any chance? Oh. Yes, good lord! Oh. It was that Herlock fellow! What? You're the surgeon that operated on Mr. Jones? That's right, using the Linus anesthesia technique, I might add. It was a fairly major op, I can tell you. This is crazy! Let me see, the fellow was brought in not long after midnight, if I remember correctly. They said he'd been shot by some criminal or other, so I opened up like a shot. The funny thing is, I went over his incisions with a fine tooth comb and couldn't find the bullet anywhere. So I'm afraid I had to throw... with my hands and just stitch the fellow back up. Hit the obvious, but yes. Surely that's because the bullet was still the scene of the shooting. The console defense is correct. As clearly shown in this photographic print, the bullet of the skull controllers fired Mr. Shrooms, hit him in the stomach. Yeah. Then as his body and launched the shop wall were seen. That actually grew the way we were thinking. I think you'll find it's considered a problem to mention. Who do you think I am, son? Well, jury number four is about the best I can do. As soon as I saw the wound on the man's stomach, I flipped him over. Like a pancake? Are you saying that you checked this back? Of course I did, and there wasn't a chance of an injury. No sign that the bullet had left us at the body at all. What? And that's the point. The only logical conclusion that the bullet was still somewhere in the man's innards. Which is exactly why I'm still excited about slicing them up. And I'm still none the wiser, even though how many times do I have to say it? Can someone explain to me how it happened? Can someone please solve this mystery? It's almost as much as a mystery as how this jury was put together.
Hold it!
Mr. Jones, sir. Injury. Surgeon is on duty. I've experienced some coincidences recently, but this is ridiculous! I'm as surprised as anyone! There's no question that Mr. Jones was shot. Well, that's what the police told me when they brought him in. I thought there was injuries, Doctor. He's in a bad way. Lost a huge amount of blood, you know. Nice, the fact he was shot at close range too. Because his skin was badly burnt to the around the point of entry. Burnt? As I said, I flipped the fellow over and examined his back. There was no sign of an exit wound. Which is why I thought I'd better locate the lab and pop it out. And yet you found no bullet inside the patient. Well, I wouldn't have done, wouldn't I? Because it's in the wall of the popper. How did they get there? I need someone to solve this mystery before it drives me insane. If only there was some expert in ballistics who could help, even if he looked extremely untrustworthy. We have a disappearing bullet in our hand. On our hand.
Hold it!
Okay. What do you mean you're in for a busy day? Forgot to say, stop. Excuse me, stop. I am the communications officer, stop. Communications officer? Does that have something to do with the sending telegrams? Every personal message is written by members of the public to the latest news in the capital. I convert all messages into mortal code and tap it to the entire world electronically. To the entire world? Thousands of miles of cable undersea, stop. Worldwide communications network, stop. Information transmitted to and from all corners of the globe, stop. Ah, yes. He was getting equally worked up about radio waves. Or the like before, wasn't she? I specialize in communication information from government departments and newspaper offices. I see. I'm sure I'll have to write to wire the newspaper's report of today's guilty verdict later. There's no sleep for me tonight, I imagine. Let's just finish the show first, shall we? I am a ballistic expert. I have seen many shootings. There's nothing I do not know about guns. I thought just a tourist. Good day. I am in London for sightseeing. I'd like to take the bus to the Crystal Tower, please. There's no way he's just wizarding tourists. So you're a ballistics expert? Hey. I have much experience with guns. Ah.
I have lived through many, how do I say, extreme, violence, bath, no, blood of,
extreme violent bloodbaths, perhaps. Or violent bloodbaths.
Not the mice! Ah, Doros, extreme violent bloodbaths.
English is very different, difficult tongue. Consider the sort of people you associate with. That's right, you still have a tongue.
Anyway, if you have questions about bullets and guns, you ask me. There is nothing I do not know, no mystery I cannot solve.
He's very confident in his knowledge of guns, that's for sure.
But if possible, please, only in Russian language.
He's not very confident in his knowledge in English, though.
No, still, you should bear it in mind.
He's our man if there's a mystery about guns or bullets. We just conveniently have it.
And seek your money to convince everyone.
And you have to eliminate the possibility. The impossible, he says, but he hasn't. We're gonna fight back. We need more material.
And we have to fight back. We have to turn this trial around again.
These two statements clearly contradict the idea that I do is pit George against each other.
Oh, a ballistic Asper.
On that question, Mr. Jones was shot by one of the Skulkin brothers. Since there's no sign of an accident in the back, we must assume that the bullet didn't pass through him. However, no bullet was found lodged in Mr. Jones' body either. Furthermore,
that bullet found lodged in the wall of the shop where Mr. Jones was shot.
Juror number 6.
Hello, my name is Phoebe. Nice to meet you.
This apparently contradicts the fact that it's so clearly troubled juror number 4. Are you able to explain the mystery?
I have seen very similar situations in Motherland.
It was night. There was a blizzard. I was running away among mountains in freezing cold.
Holy.
The snow was piling up on both sides of the road. It was very narrow and dangerous. My pursuers was hunting rifles, and they were on dog sled. Mental note. Don't ask too many questions. I was shot from behind and fell down in the snow. And this situation was very similar to what I heard today from Doctor. They could not have found bullets in my body. There were no signs, how do I say, axe's wound.
Then where did the bullet go?
Bullet never hit me.
But will never hit you? Where did you fall down?
Bullet hit frozen wall of ice very close to my side.
What?
One small piece, very sharp, broke away from of ice and pierced my body. It made a deep wound that looked like bullet wound.
Good gracious!
First, piece of ice quickly melted inside me. And that's the solution to mysterious of disappearing bullet.
But that doesn't answer your question at all.
It shouldn't happen in the pawnbroker shop.
Not some snowy mountain road in another country.
Just an idea. We might not be looking at exactly the same scenario here. Bruno.
Where exactly was who shot again?
Well, according to the report, in his stomach, some of horrendous area, I think.
Well, that's precisely where he all.
Which was all pouch in his belt. Pouch? Actually, man knows something like that.
Yes, a pouch!
It's where he keeps three glass vials of very dangerous chemicals that he uses in his investigation. What? Really? Doctor! Where is the pouch that Mr. Jones was wearing?
Well,
the fellow had nothing I got on his person when he ran to the hospital, as far as I remember.
Hi, May. Lord Francique! While I realize it is forbidden for the prosecution to interject during a summary examination, I should inform the defendant that I have the pouch in question in the antechamber outside the courtroom.
Sorry?
As I understand it, when the police arrived on the scene and found Mr. Sholmes injured, they removed the pouch in order to search the wound.
Ah, thank goodness. I thought it was getting forgetful for a moment.
Instead, it has been in my safekeeping along with all other evidence related to the case. I can personally vouch for the fact that it has not been touched since the incident occurred. Very well. While extremely inconvenienced during the surreal sound, I must demand the prosecution present the item in question with all speed.
Bring forth Mr. Sherlock Holmes' pouch!
Oh, Sholmes. Whoops.
I see. This is the pouch where Mr. Sholmes and the knight in question is then. Look at that! One of the vials is broken and the letter around is scorched black. That was the fifth. The file exploded!
Exploded?
Boom, that nine. The bullet from the Skullcrabber's gun struck Mr. Sholmes' pouch. And the glass file exploded that caused the fellow's injury. This bullet did not penetrate Fegan, but was deflected into a wall of shop.
A delightful complex aroma. Well, it would appear one mystery has been solved at least. Though it has no bearing on the truth of the case. The bungling and burgling brother shot the detective, and the accused shot the pawnbroker. The pertinent facts of the case remains unaltered.
At least the mystery was solved. I can sleep easy tonight. Thank you, young man.
Ah, thank you very much. Glad I could help.
Who is the Baron? This conundrum just saw at the court when I suspiciously the Scruffy purchased evidence. Who's purchasing Scruffy?
Scruffy? His purchase has at least been added to the court records, though.
Nine, the summary examination.
It appeared the defense is somewhat struggling with alternative options.
Please, my lord, a little more time. After all, this new piece of evidence, it could be a valuable clue. And you can't afford to overlook anything here.
There's still a way to turn this around, somehow. I'm sure of it.
Hold it!
Okay. And I ask you to reconsider your lien, sir.
Oh no, that's another matter entirely.
Sorry?
All I can think about for the moment is that wonderful sense of relief I have that the mystery is solved. I need some time to look at this thing before I could possibly consider anything else.
Alright. Technical surgeons have to be able to think quickly.
Perhaps we should leave him alone for now while he savors his inner peace. And focus on some other jurors. I suppose we have to. I wish I had a chance to experience some inner peace at times.
Okay. This fails and smashed to pieces. Similarly, this is where the bullet struck. Since the bullet hit the chemicals in a file, there would have been a really big explosion.
Well, Harry's potions and chemicals are majorly useful for investigation work he does.
They're also quite tricky to handle. Safely, at least, they're very dangerous.
Oh. I'm sure when this file broke, the chemicals inside moved up at night.
Note to self. Always walk on the right hand side of shrooms in the future. The left is a danger zone.
Oh, look! There's a hole here in the back. Isn't
a hole, but clearly something ripped through the letter before us.
Someone must have pierced it somehow to leave this hole behind.
Yes, it looks that way.
The Shones and his pouch both took a beating, didn't they?
It's written. They score badly just here.
Oh, the strap is broken. Look. This must have been when a bullet hit Dan.
Let me see.
What the? Iris, look! Behind the broken valve is... Do you see it? Ah, that's...
It's called compressed bullet. What a stroke of luck that I hit the pouch, his pouch. That's this amazing discovery.
This means is... There were three bullets fired in Winting Bank Banks that night. Exactly what that you're talking about. The fur bullet. It's time to press the jar again, I think. We found a bullet. Thank you, Mr. Sholmes.
The football's lunch. Imagine what would have happened if it pierced the letter. I couldn't have assumed this is going to be alright.
Oh, that thing got dented.
It's gonna be the fall of the fire from Mr. Shokun's brother's gun.
Yes, so it turns out it was never actually entered Shiryu's spot at all.
Thanks to the thick letter of the pouch he was wearing, it saved him.
He was always lucky like that. Well, considering what he had to go through in the hospital, I wonder how lucky he really was. Oh dear, poor Hurry. But now I can. That literally just flipped us.
I'm gonna show you then. The third bullet.
Take that!
Here is. The third bullet. We discovered it just now.
Yes! On the next question, then when. Banks Palm Brewery, another bullet was fired! What is this new trickery, you Nipponese conjurer? Where did you find that bullet?
It was lodged inside Mr. Shones' pouch.
What?
This pouch was removed from Mr. Shones' waist before he was taken to the hospital. Since then, it hasn't been touched. It has been touched by no one.
You mean to say... Shot fire by the Skogmurders that night.
Yes, your lordship, has summarized. It hit the pouch.
But that makes no sense whatsoever.
We already know the whereabouts of the bullet fire from Mr. Sholmes. Mr. Sholmes.
It's clearly visible in this photographic print.
Ah!
Two guns from the scene have already been summarized in the court record as evidence.
Yes, that was a remake. And not belonging to the Skulking Brothers.
And as an examination of both guns reveal that only a single bullet has been fired from each.
Ah!
But that means...
That's right. We now know that on the next question, three bullets were fired.
However, only two bullets were fired from the gun recovered from the scene, from the crime scene. Until an unconscious... inconsistency is somehow explained. We cannot and must not pass judgment.
While this decision sound remains incomplete, the court has been presented with new facts. Facts that would appear to shake the firm foundation upon which this case against the defendant has been built.
As is my prerogative in this situation, I hereby temporarily suspend this summary examination. I drew up a... 1.
Elif? Bring the witnesses back to the stand at once.
Huh.
Why is Grayson always present? But now I know why. Witnesses? Governor? Were you listening to the proceedings while the defendants carry out the examination?
We was, Governor. We was.
Perhaps we can dispense with this preamble. Simply answer this one question. A third bullet has been identified at the scene of the crime. What do you make of that?
Give it, Gov. I don't.
Is it funny?
I don't know. I don't make nothing if I can't help it.
Is it one of yours?
Go blimey, not a chance.
In that case, did you have an accomplice?
What? Never! The Skull Converters didn't work alone. It was just the two of us. That's our trademark.
As soon we forget poor Skull. Only two of the bullets from the crime scene originated from the firearms we have in evidence. The third bullet was fired from another gun. Where is it?
Oh wait, that's a scratcher.
Counsel of Defense.
Yes?
I should like to hear your thoughts regarding the third bullet and the mysterious missing firearm from Mrs. Kim. Thinking back over all the testimony we have heard and all the evidence we've seen, I'm starting to form a picture. I'm not sure of what really happened that night. Lord, this clear the bullet tells us about the Skulkin Brothers. I believe it has nothing to do with them.
Eh? Nice. That's right. Yeah, nothing to do with us, Gov.
We established that one bullet was fired from each of the two guns already known to the court. The last conclusion, therefore, is that on the night of in question of Mr. Windy Banks' pawnbroker raid, there was another person present in possession of a third firearm.
Whilst the brothers may have nothing to do with the third gun or bullet fired from it,
it's inconceivable that it had nothing to do with the third man.
Yes, the brothers were working with an accomplice who was carrying a gun.
An accomplice, you say? Pixwell.
These protracted proceedings have already forced us to endure two summation examinations. Yet in all that time, there's been no murder of a third man. If this apparently wraith-like being exists,
the court must be shown hard evidence. Without it, its fantasy will be crushed.
The prosecution demands answer on two counts.
Firstly, proof, evidence that this accomplice was ever at the scene of the crime. And secondly,
the identity of the spurious character.
First, I knew it. The music disc, and I know I have an idea who it will be.
What?
How can I assert an identity person in their hiding?
Well, counsel.
It's supposed to prove the assistance of this accomplice and reveal the person's identity, even? Oh, my lord, defense is.
Let's try.
Defense is ready. I believe I can provide all the answers to the prosecution's demands. Someone even needs ran. Despite the swimming eyes, you seem. Think you have something to say. This promises to be interesting.
Push forward 9. There's no other option. I have to use every single piece of evidence to me. It will make a difference.
In that case, counsel, I'd like to ask you to present evidence without delay. Only in question, in the moments leading up to the death of the victim, what proof do you...
Take that!
The evidence is this. Oh. Well, I would think... Then it's right here, in this portfolio. My God, that portfolio, Guinnessen? Of course! Do you expect the court to rifle through your papers itself? Be more specific. You claim one of these blood samples proves the presence of her so well. Which one is it?
Take that!
What am I looking at here? Appears to be some green paint or such like around the bullet hole in the inside of the calendar. That's a blessing, my lord. Stain? Green blood? Curious, even for you. Is the court to understand that the intruder was some unhuman creature? It's something developed by Mr. Herlock Shumes. Ah, the great detective? The infection, stop! Never appeared in the stories. Stop. It's this, you see? It doesn't have a name yet, though. This fucker sprays a chemical that reacts to different elements of people's blood and changes its color. Different elements of people's blood? Yes, everyone's blood is slightly different, you see? Because it's made up of different elements. So by seeing what color it changes to, you can tell the flesh whose blood it is. And vegetables, ooh, that brings a whole extra dimension to looking at blood. Tuck up blood in the court and stop. Very exciting, stop! As an example, this one shows the blood of the victim, Mr. Winniebank. Ah, a striking blue. Yes, so you see, the green color of this blood stain on this calendar shows that someone else was shot in the main part of the shop. Hold your fire there, young man. Could this be from some unrelated instance, couldn't it? No, it's not unrelated. The date shown on the calendar is the date on which Mr. Winniebank was killed. By golly! However, we can assume that whoever was shot on the same day. Then whose blood is it? Well, the skull bearers in the stand don't appear to be suffering from any gunshot injuries. Which means that it must be blood from someone else. The third intruder, in fact.
Objection!
Whose identity in the court is still waiting to hear? You can't delay us any longer, my learned friend. Who is the alleged third intruder?
Take that!
The man's name is Edgar Benedict. Edgar Benedict? Who are you talking about, counsel? He had visited the Winniebank's pawnbrokery on the afternoon before the incident took place. And the accused attempted to deceive the pawnbroker into releasing this article into their possession. That's right.
Manson identity by the defense, Mr. Egbert Benedict. Dannon attempted to take the article from the defendant by force.
Broca?
Yes, sir. I believe that filthy pocket thief has just redeemed an article from you, no?
Yes.
The article in question belongs to me. I demand it to be returned at once. Now that's a lie. What are you trying to pull? Give me back my overcoat, you runs, Mistral, and needless to say. Any music bosses, too. Inspector Grayson was there at the time and can attest to what happened. In the end, it was the inspector himself who took the disc. Can you collaborate on this current, Inspector?
Yes, my lord. That more or less what happened.
In the interest of being thorough, I asked Winnie Bank for prints showing the fellow. Take it from one of his rent hunt the recorders did the business.
Yes. That's him talking to Mr. Winnie Bank that morning.
You claim this man is the brother's accomplice? Well, Mrs. Skulkin.
Never seen the geezer before in my life. All my life, Gotham. All my life, never seen him.
Well, somewhat unsurprising, it appears our witnesses disagree with the assertion. I'm sure your lordship recalls my learned Nipponese friend's actual assertion, which was that he could prove the identity of the alleged accomplice.
Yes, and I can.
Then show us the evidence.
I agree.
We'll see proof that the clean-cut gentleman in the photograph is a filthy criminal that you say he is.
This is the last piece of evidence. I have a feeling that something's been missing from this trial from the very start. And I'm going to drag it kicking and screaming into the courtroom.
Are you ready to present your answer to the question? The court, then, counsel?
Yes, my lord.
The defense will present the evidence now. Proof to the man.
Take that!
As I mentioned before, on the afternoon of the question, the defendant attempted deceitfully, admittedly, to reclaiming this disc from Windy Bank. Which was when the aforementioned Benedict appeared on the scene, I believe. This man attempted to purloin the article from the defendant's possession, no?
That's correct, my lord. I myself was present at the time.
It was following this that a minor incident occurred. Of course, sir. Here's a disc for you.
Very well.
Then I shall bid you photo. Say goodbye to my style.
Wait a minute. That disc.
It's mine.
God, what? What have you done? What are you doing, you little... Drawn blood, you filthy animal.
Being the music box disc, it had cracked with small but sharp metal precision. Patrusions over the surface. Those patrusions caused around his finger to bleed, and resulting in a smear of blood is still visible on the disc and eye.
Quickness, a bloodstain, is it?
My assistant and I had just analyzed the bloodstain here in this very courtroom, using my trusty fogger gun. Yes, and we added the results to this portfolio.
I say, it's green!
It's the exact same color as the blood around the calendar. The evidence is conclusive. The man calling himself Mr. Edgar Benedict, who was in Mr. Windy Banks earlier in the day, is the accomplice who was present at the scene of the crime that same night. But it was something else. Look at those two brothers now. They're sweating bullets. Wait, what are you talking about? It's boiling in here.
Really? Did I?
Okay. Hello? It is the opinion of the defense that Mr. Ekbrenik should be summoned to the courtroom to testify. It would certainly seem that we can ill afford to ignore this gentleman's apparent presence.
Objection.
This has gone on long enough now. A fragment of ignorance of the mechanics of law. Perlaxion, you say? Yes, I've heard the name. A protagonist in a series of short stories for the full bigger classes. God, the attraction of or some sorts. Ouch. At night, you employ chemical substance devised by this fascinating persona in the highest court of the land. You expect us to take you seriously? The samples made by this plaything are not fit to be called evidence. So the blessing turned a shade of green. What of it? Yes, you're success in proving that no other blood in the world could turn the same color. Ah, well. There is the foot! And pray, do not even think of suggesting that we should take Mr. Sholmes' word for it. The foot's gone. That's right. Mr. Sholmes can cock. Right? Is Mr. Shrooms' concoction a little rubbish? I don't know. I mean, he's a great detective. What are you talking about? We can't let him get away with that. You know, come down to this. Of course, Mr. Shrooms' invention isn't going to be recognized by any official bodies. But what are choices that I have? I just remember what Father Christmas over there said before. About how he was temporarily suspending the rise examination. Ah! In other words, the examination isn't over yet, is it? Good grief! What did you say, young girl? In the summary of the examination, the decision as to whether or not the trial continues is in the hands of the six jurors, isn't it? So the way I see it, it doesn't matter what certain other people think of Huey's invention. At least, not for now. Yes, she's right! Lady, you have quite the devious mind. It really just comes into one thing. Whether these ladies and gentlemen of the jury are convinced by what you said, Bruno. Is that about right, would you say? Or did I misunderstand something? Believable. Mr. Sholmes' partner is a force to be reckoned with. Iris Wilson, sharpshooter. After the shrewd pursuit of the situation for an entirely unexplained like the source, it must be acknowledged that the previous summary is of Yasuyemi's conclusion. This is absurd! Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the court now looks to you for your fine leanings on this matter. As proud citizens of Her Majesty Britain, I'm sure we'll come to a fair and just conclusion. So then, state your final decision in terms, please.
Not guilty.
Not guilty.
Not guilty.
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 Not guilty.
It's 4-2! Which means the trial continues. 2 calls guilty and 4 call not guilty. Such is an outcome of the summary examination.
Objection.
My lord, with all due respect, this is an outrage. Prosecution refuses to accept this decision. On what grounds? If these jurors are persuaded by some half-bit concoction devised by a pretender of real police work, then they are too ignorant to be trusted with judgment of anyone's guilt.
I'm sorry, Lord Panseek. The outcome of the Sumerian Sound cannot be ignored. The trial will continue! Nevertheless, we find ourselves in a rather awkward situation. The defense has very recently requested the subpoena of a new witness. But sadly, I fear that will be impossible. What? The name of the gentleman gave for himself, Agrippa Benedict, is quite clearly false. I don't believe it. Just when I managed to print the mom a star that night. Did I say something? Who was that, please? Who spoke? It was me, my lord. You're number 5? What have you said, madame? Impossible. Inspector? Me, madame? Huh? I wonder if you might show this photographic print again. The one which the gentleman is showing. Ah, right, yes. This one, you mean. Of Mr. Benedict. Yes. There's no doubt in my mind. You're number 5? You don't mean to say... know this man? Yes, I know him. What? No! Oh, good gracious! Order! 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 You're number 5. How on earth? I am a communications officer. Stop. As we can clearly see... the gentleman in the photograph is... stop. Also a communications officer. Stop. He works in my office. Stop. Look at her eyes. A very talented operator, in fact. Stop. He should be in the communications office. Sorry, communication station 9. Stop. Tapping away on the telegram. Stop. This doesn't seem right somehow. I can't put my finger on why, but it doesn't feel right. I suppose we all imagine the accomplice would be some sort of hardened criminal. But the suspect of the finding that he has a respectable job by day, whatever he gets up to at night. Yes, I suppose that's it. I suppose that's why I felt something was wrong. This gentleman is at London's communication station. We should be able to subpoena him within the hour. Lord Panseek, if you please. Yes, my lord. Take necessary arrangements with all haste. As your lordship bids. The court will recess for 1 hour. And when the new witness arrives, we should reconvene to hear the gentleman's testimony. Inspector Rayson? Yes, my lord? I should like to hear from you specifically about a fence at the pawnbroker on the day in question. Come to my chamber during recess. Yes, sir, my lord. Very well. Court is adjourned until 1:40 p.m. And I think that could be a nice little stopping point, because I think that's part... yeah, that's part 2. This entire stream was just the second part of this trial. Wow, that's a long... this is a long one. We've been at this for at least 3 days. This is day number 4. And we're going to day number 5. I think we'll wrap things up for now, if that's alright with everyone else. Alright, I'll run things up here. Thanks for everyone tuning in. Hope it's a good day. Hope it's a good week. We'll be back on this Wednesday on tomorrow. If anyone's watching this on Twitch, YouTube is going to be probably way down the line whenever I can actually get these on the channel, on my channel. Who knows when that's going to be. We will be returning to this. We'll return to Monster, but I don't know if we're doing stories 2 or anything else. I'm going to have to debate about that one. I don't know, though. Like I said, I'll wrap things up here. Thanks for all tuning in. Hope it's a good day. Hope it's a good week. I will see you all next time. Bye.